Hey, my friends, it's Gene. Get up, get out with Gene. I got Nala with me right here. So we're gonna do a video for you right here. I'm actually sitting down, look, chilling out, got shorts on, sitting at the lake here, getting ready to fall backwards down this hill. But Nala told me she wanted to do a video today about how great things have been, in the past several months, right? So since, I'd say July, like, some big changes happened in my life. Got custody of my kid, you know, my relationship changed, into a supportive and, loving relationship, you know, which was unexpected. Come here, Nala. And this girl came into our life some point over the summer. I can't remember when it was. Some shortly after, my boy got here. But, and I've been doing these videos and things have been going really, really good. And I've noticed over the last several months that things have changed for me, you know, mentally and physically, even with all the good things going on. Like, some things I started to do for myself physically weren't good. You know what I mean? Like, I've been in celebratory mode. Is that a word? Celebratory. Like, I've been celebrating. That's what I'm trying to say. But I've been in that kind of mode there for the past several months and kind of let myself go a little bit. And I've noticed, I check the scale often because I'm pretty proud of, you know, what I've accomplished over the past couple years and everything. And I check the scale often and I keep track of what's going on with me health-wise. And I've noticed that I've gained a whole bunch of weight over the past several months. Because, you know why? And this is the reason what I wanted to get into here. And it's all about a mental thing for me, and I'm gonna fix this very soon. I've been thinking about it a lot, is that I've been so happy that I've been just like so many good things going on in family, especially, you know, with having Nash and then my girl in my life now and her family. You know, we celebrate a lot. A lot of birthdays, a lot of the holidays have come and gone, you know, and there's a lot of eating and there's a lot of hanging out and just having a good time. I'm not drinking or anything like that, which is a great thing, you know, but there's been a lot of eating and a lot of eating. And here's the thing in my head, and this happened too, even like a few years ago before I even started with ID Life or anything, when I was up in Maryland a lot, helped my mom out, is that I feel like I don't like to have leftovers. I don't like putting stuff away. So I eat everything I possibly can that's in front of me. And I'm surprised I actually haven't put on a lot more weight. And I wanna say too, actually, let me switch positions here because I really feel like I'm gonna fall down this hill, fall backwards right into the lake. Probably some gators back here watch me too, but Nala will protect me. But you know, with all these great things going on, I've been celebrating and eating and eating and eating. There's been so much good food. You know, we're in the South, you know, there's tons of great food, and I've been lucky enough to have that all around me. I've been going out and like trying to support local businesses too, and getting out and eating out a lot too, which is a very good thing to do. But I don't know how to eat good stuff. I like to go out and eat burgers and steaks and pastas and meats and all kinds of stuff. So I've been celebrating a lot, and it's a good thing. Life is good. Life is really good. I'm very happy with where it's at right now. But I gotta say, it's all in my mind up here. And I understand on the opposite spectrum too, that a lot of people that are bummed out and that type of thing, you know, might overeat also. You know, I totally understand that. So it's good for us if we can find like a happy medium somewhere in the middle. But here's my thing of what I'm thinking about with my overeating. This is what I'm thinking about, is with overeating and or eating stuff that's not great for you, you know, that it tends to change the makeup of your body. It tends to change, obviously, the way you look, the way you feel, your gut, which is my problem, you know, but it also changes what's going on up here mentally. You know, some of those foods and stuff aren't good for you mentally either. And I think that's what's been going on with me. I've been down, I've been feeling more, not necessarily sick, like colds or flu or anything like that, but just not right. You know what I mean? I haven't been feeling right. And this is going on over this weekend too. I started getting my ear just got plugged up and I wasn't feeling right. And then yesterday I had a slight fever for some reason. Not sure. I think I might have gotten bit by something on my hand. Maybe a spider or something. I can't tell what it is. But that could have something to do with it too. But either way, I know that my sense of overeating, what I like to do to get into the food and just overdo it, especially since I have my boy and when we're at home, it's just me and him. And we'll just eat crappy food because that's what guys do, right? So I've been just eating the wrong things and it's affecting who I am and what I am. So here's what I gotta do is change my thinking. I gotta change that when I go to eat, one plate is good enough. When I feel full, it's good enough. It's okay to stop then. Cause my thing is, even if I feel full, I'll go back and get another plate. And then there's dessert too. And who doesn't want dessert? You know, I love dessert. I like cake. I like ice cream. I like pies. I like it all. So what I gotta do is I gotta change this mindset that things, portions gotta be smaller, you know? If Nala's rolling all over here, let me pour her back up. But portions have gotta be smaller. You know, I don't have to eat until I gorge myself. And, you know, I'm doing the right things. Nala, you're gonna end up in the lake. Come here. I'm doing the right things with getting out on walks and hitting a gym when I can. And, you know, I keep myself busy and I'm doing gigs and this and that. So, just to make it even better, I gotta start working on my portion control and think about what I'm eating. You know, because I do my shake still in the morning and I add avocado and I add spinach and some honey and blueberries. And I did that this morning, that type of thing. Maybe some other stuff that's my vegan shake with Adi Life. But so I do that right. I do things. I take my vitamins. If it weren't for my vitamins, I really believe that I would be in a much worse off position. So I'm okay, but I got to work on some things. I'm okay, but I got to work on some things. That's that, you know. And I don't want to say that what I do with Adi Life, the protein shakes or my vitamins or anything like that, or any type of magic pill or anything like that, because they definitely are not a magic pill. Anybody that tells you any health and wellness product is a magic pill is full of BS. I'll keep it clean. They're full of BS, you know? And I see people even with Adi Life that are taking vitamins and stuff, you know, but still, you know, are heavier set and this and that. It's because they're not exercising. They're not doing the things, proper things you need to do. You need to add, if you're going to do some health and wellness stuff, maybe take some proper vitamins or use some other products or things like that. You still have to exercise. You still have to eat right. You still have to maintain your health and wealth. You know what I mean? That's what's inside of you. Your health and wealth is inside of you. So, you know, just think about that. I'm not trying to pitch anything because I know what I'm doing and I know what's helped me out. And I know that I'd be in a much worse off place if I wasn't taking my customized vitamins every day, if I wasn't doing my shakes every day, if I wasn't drinking my hydrate every day. You know, I wouldn't be out here to walk Nala and all that. So I know I'm doing the right thing. It's just I got to work on some things. You know, because there are no magic pills. Adi Life isn't a magic pill or anything like that. I've got to work on some things. I got to work on my portion controls. I got to maybe get to the gym more often or exercise a little bit more. Maybe do some more yoga or stuff like that. You know what I mean? So that's that. So I've been in celebratory mode for the past several months because a lot of good things have happened. And I've been partying it up in a way with eating. You know, I'm not drinking and smoking and all that stuff anymore. But I've been eating a lot. So what I gotta do is just fix that. I'm gonna still be happy. I'm gonna still be in celebratory mode and thankful for all the good things that are in my life, including this goofy girl right here and my girlfriend and my son and my life and, you know, everything around me and work and this and that and the beautiful lake behind me and a beautiful day like this. You know, how can I not celebrate? So I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna think about it before, you know. I live in excess. Even when I'm drinking, you know, people are like, well, I could just have one drink and that's great. I couldn't do that. I couldn't just have one drink or one shot, you know, I'd have 10 shots, 10 drinks or whatever. And that would just lead me into idiocy, basically. So it's more of a mental thing. Maybe I need some help with that. Maybe I have a little of an addiction to overdoing things, but that's, I'll work on that. All right. But that's about it. So I hope maybe this video helps you. And I just wanted to explain my story. And I know that's not really per se helping anybody out, but maybe my story can help you out. Maybe you can share this with other people that might be going through the same thing. Or even if you're down and you're overeating, it's understandable. I get down too, and I'm like, I need some cake or ice cream or whatever, need to feel better, need a sugar rush, you know what I mean? So, you know, it goes both ways. So I'm trying to find a middle ground. I'm gonna work on myself and hopefully I can help some other people, maybe one person today or two, three, four, five today. And let's see what we can do. If this helps you, you know, share my videos. I put them all up on YouTube. I haven't really done a video since last week when Nash and I were up in Maryland, getting around the lake there, and just decided I just didn't want to. Wasn't sure I wanted to today. I'm not feeling well. I've been in bed all morning, just working from bed. Pardon me, Nala. Working from bed, and I was like, I need to get out in the sunshine. My girl Robin reminded me that it's going to be a beautiful day to be off work, so here we are. And I'm doing it. And I'm sorry it's a long video, and I hope you can watch it all. Maybe just sit down later when you got some free time. I'm sure you're working or you're doing some busy things today. But hopefully you're getting up and getting out. And let's do this together. Maybe you can help me, you know, and I can help you. And let's just work together with it and see what we can do, all right? If you can, get out and enjoy a view like this. If you can't, do what you gotta do. Get up and walk around. Get up and do things. If you got a dog, get out and walk your dog. All right. I love you guys. Thank you very much. Jump on my website, gugogene.com, and all my videos are posted there, and I share them from YouTube. So get by there, gugogene.com. All right. I love you guys. Peace. Chicken grease. Thank you very much for everything. I love you guys. See ya.